What's going on? Mel Ayres, alive, always living in view of eternity.
Always.
Rightfully named.
Come on.
This is the hour.
Seem like the end times.
Jesus, we're keeping our 6 feet, our social distancing here now.
We're practicing.
Amen.
We're practicing.
Yeah.
It's good to be here.
Jesus.
How you doing? You doing good?
Blessed, yeah.
Yeah.
These are interesting times.
Interesting times.
You know, but Jesus is still on the throne. That's my response.
The times are crazy, but God's good all the time.
Yeah.
Right?
Amen.
He's good all the time. So.
Amen.
We have nothing to be nervous about. You know, the Lord is good, and He turns all things around for our good.
That's right.
So we just, you know, you just have to give it a second.
Amen.
You know, not everything happens every split moment, but if you trust in the Lord, cast all your care over on Him. Remember that He cares for you.
Mm.
You're not built to care for you. He cares for you, right?
Jesus.
So if you start carrying that care, it builds up, it breaks your body down. That's where arthritis comes from. That's where a lot of sickness and disease comes from.
Wow.
Heart failure, you're carrying too much. That muscle's not meant to carry.
Mm-hmm.
And so you have to cast all your care over on Him.
Yeah, was it?
Cast your
care on Him?
Care on the Lord.
Yeah.
He cares for you.
Mm-hmm.
So it's good. It's all good. We had some interesting things happen this week.
Mm.
We have been having services, and I've been listening to all the mayor's speeches and everything, and he never mentions churches. He never mentions mosques. He never mentions temples.
Mm.
And so I just took it that the church could gather and meet.
Mm-hmm.
He talked about essential businesses open, that laundromats were open and plumbers were open and law offices were open, car dealerships. I thought, well, surely he means that the church is open. It's much more essential than those things.
Amen.
Even those have their own measure of validity, right?
That's right.
But last night, I had a call from the district attorney's office, and she got very annoyed with me because I said, listen, we have a right to assemble peacefully.
Yeah.
It's been there for a couple hundred years now.
The very first one, right?
Yeah. So, but didn't agree with me. They sent 6 officers over.
Wow.
And they just walked up last night as we're getting ready to have service and shut us down.
Jesus.
You know, they threatened to turn off our water and power and fine us and all that kind of thing. And I thought, okay, well, you know what? God is good.
Amen.
And so we're looking forward to being online until this thing blows over. And when it does blow over, our online presence will still be awesome.
Yeah.
You know, we'll have something that we hadn't thought about majoring in.
Yeah.
But we'll be great online, reaching more people. So if you want to watch us, make sure you find us online, right?
I mean, the website, the thing about online is its ability to catch those, you know, looky-loos, you know, and there are some people who have just never heard the gospel or never heard it in a way in which it's articulated through, you know, certain people. I know the anointing of God is tangible. It's real here in the house of God. Wherever the word of God is proclaimed, you know, the presence of God is there. So we are doing it, you know, www.ihpchurch.org, In His Presence Church LA, on Facebook, on YouTube as well.
Yeah.
People are watching.
Yeah.
People are watching.
Yeah, I mean, we're having, I think we had well over 4,000 people watch this last week.
Yeah.
And we were having church.
Yeah.
We were here and we were online. And so,
you
know, we want to reach as many people as we can with the gospel.
That's right.
You know, we got into this because we're called.
Yeah.
You know, and that's our mission from the Lord, is to win souls and make disciples.
Amen.
And so we're doing that.
Amen.
Yeah. So we've been talking about healing, right?
Woo. Yes, we have.
I think that we ought to talk about healing, but also, you know, I'm feeling that maybe end times revelation stuff might be popping out pretty soon here.
Yeah.
You know, I've been thinking about that and thinking about, you know, people are thinking, is this the end times? No.
Hmm.
The coronavirus is not a sign of the end times. I mean, it is a sign of the birth pains. But in the end times, just in the first couple of years, 1 billion people perish. So we don't really have that going on right now. And, you know, they all fall into place. There's the end times stuff that you see, and then the rapture of the church, and then the Antichrist takes his place, and we're going to talk about that. If you'd like to hear more about that, then why don't you get in touch with us? How do they connect with us so they can say, hey, we want to be a part of that when you start talking about that?
It's going to be those same platforms. You'll see it on the screen, you know, www.ihpchurch.org. You're also, please, please stay connected to us. Make sure you subscribe and hit that notification at In His Presence Church LA on YouTube as well as Facebook. So those
Send
are the platforms
we're
using. Yeah.
We'd love to hear your questions.
Yeah.
You know, we'd love to hear your questions about what days are we in, about heaven, about hell, about the rapture of the church, the second coming of Christ, the tribulation, lake of fire. All that stuff is so interesting, and the Bible's very clear about it. So we'd love to hear those, and I'd be glad to answer those questions for you. That might be a good start for us. Just send some questions in, and I'll be answering those for you.
Amen.
You know, in Psalms 107, it talks about that he sent his word and healed them. That word that he's talking about is the word of God, Jesus Christ. In John 1:1-4, it's he's in the beginning was the word was with God, the word was God, he was in the beginning with God, everything that was made through him, by him. And so we see that Jesus Christ is the Word of God, that he's there in heaven, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Father, his will is pronounced. Jesus speaks it out, and then the Holy Spirit creates it, gives it power, and then all of a sudden he says, let there be light. Bam, there is light. And so we love it that Jesus Christ is the Word of God. In Isaiah 53, let's turn there. That's a great scripture for everybody watching. You'd want to underline this. Isaiah 53, verse 4. Surely he's borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Talking about Jesus on the cross. Yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God and afflicted. He was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. His chastisement of his peace was upon him. Our chastisement was upon him, and by his stripes we were healed. I love that. Everybody say it with me. By his stripes,
we
were healed.
We were healed. Amen.
In Matthew 8, and if you'll look around verse 14, let's look at that. These two go together. This would be a great Bible study that you could have with people at your house, a great way to explain that God's will is that we're healed. Matthew 8, come on, don't let people talk you into that God puts stuff on you, cancer and all this stuff on you. It's not true. His will is that through Jesus Christ, we've received his mercy and his grace and his love. His love is Jesus Christ, has no beginning and no end. But in Matthew 8, talks about in verse 16, when evening had come, he brought to him many who were demon-possessed. He cast out the spirits with a word and healed all who were sick. You ought to underline that. He healed all who were sick. Now, if the Father's putting sickness on us, why is Jesus healing it? That means he's working against the Father. So we can see that Jesus is not antagonistic towards the Father. They are in complete harmony and agreement. Same spirit.
Same spirit.
So it says that he might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet. He took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. In Isaiah, he calls it griefs and sorrows. But Jesus translates it here that it's physical ailment. That he took our infirmities and our sicknesses. So your healing is under the atonement that happened on the cross as Jesus paid for our sins. I want to say it this way. You're as healed as you are saved.
Amen.
But both of those things must be appropriated by faith. To be saved, you have to put your faith in Jesus Christ. To be healed, you must believe and trust that he did that on the cross, that he paid for all that on the cross. And he tells the man at Jericho, according to your faith, be it unto you. Right? He said, if that's what you want, if that's what you believe, then healing is yours.
Mm.
So I want us to get that.
Mm.
Because we're kind of wishy-washy about when stuff comes. Is it God? Is it the devil? And we got to figure out who the good guy is and who the bad guy is.
Mm-hmm.
God is a good one. The devil's the bad guy. That's what Desiree says all the time.
Mm.
He bore all that on the cross for us. Right? 2,000 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So we're healed. We eat coronavirus for breakfast.
Amen.
Come on. Every sickness and disease that comes our way, by his stripes, we were healed.
Amen.
That's our confession.
That's right.
He sent his word and healed us.
Mm-hmm.
If he be for us, who can stand successfully against us?
Mm-hmm.
You have to stand strong in the Lord and the power of his might.
That's right.
Right? You can't be wishy-washy. If you're double-minded, the Bible says, you can't receive anything.
Mm.
A double-minded man
unstable.
Is unstable in all his ways.
All of them.
How do we be stable?
Jesus.
In the word of God.
Mm-hmm.
We have the word of God. Right?
That's right.
Amen. So, you know, when Jesus is walking around healing people, it's just not his mercy and compassion and his benevolent character.
Mm-hmm.
It really is that it's his will that you're healed.
Mm.
And that he wants them to know that through me, healing is provided for you.
Mm.
He hasn't died on the cross yet, but he's transitioning from the Old Testament, an eye for an eye,
mm-hmm.
moving into a New Testament of grace and mercy and compassion
yeah.
and healing.
Yeah.
And he's saying, man, in me, you're going to receive healing.
Mm.
And he's healing people.
Jesus.
So, praise God.
Praise God.
Yeah. You know, in Matthew 11, Prince, I love this. I quote this a lot.
Mm-hmm.
John the Baptist sends a couple of disciples and says, are you the one, or do we wait for another?
Mm-hmm.
And John knows that he's the one.
Mm-hmm.
Because the Father's already shown him, and he has said it, behold, the Lamb who's come to take away the sin of the world.
Mm-hmm.
He got a revelation from God. But he's annoyed because he's in prison. Jesus hasn't come and seen him yet.
Mm.
John is giving up his ministry as Jesus is being taken over the ministry.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's a little rough on him. So he sends a couple of disciples to question him. And Jesus says this, go and tell John what you've seen and heard.
Mm.
The blind see, the deaf hear, the dumb speak, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed,
mm-hmm.
and the gospel is preached to the poor. The
mm-hmm.
good news is preached to the poor. So he verifies who he is
mm-hmm.
by the miraculous healings that are happening.
Mm.
So we know that it's his will that we're healed. In fact, I don't know, I might get in trouble. Some people might get annoyed. He said, follow me, I'll make you fishers of men. If we're following Jesus, then people in our lives should be seeing healing in their life.
Mm.
Because his life is in us and we're in him, right?
That's right.
Okay, so I believe that Christians need to stand up today and begin to lay hands on the sick. Well, there's a lot of people that that need us today.
That's right.
When we get it back into our jobs and we're around people, those people need to know that there's healing in you, pouring out of you.
Yeah.
When he touched the leper, life came out of him.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And the leprosy was cleansed. Right around the corner, he went to Peter's house and touched his mother-in-law with the same hand.
Mm.
Life poured out of him.
Mm-hmm.
And now he said that we're in him and he's in us.
Mm-hmm.
And if we're in him, there's no sickness in him,
no
disease, but life. The devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy. I've come to give you life, life more abundantly.
Amen.
I know I'm going on and on and on, but
the same
it's a great
spirit
subject.
That rose Jesus from the dead is alive in us.
Same spirit.
Right? So that's
let me finish
it
off
for you.
Got that
same power.
Quickening our mortal body.
Come on.
That means bringing healing and wholeness.
Yeah.
To our mortal bodies,
Jesus.
These bodies.
Yeah.
Not our glorified body, these bodies. That same spirit that raised him from the dead with victory over death, hell, and the grave is now living in us, the Holy Spirit, and he's bringing the life of God to our mortal bodies.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, we should be the most healed people on the earth.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Now, the attacks come to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And oh my gosh, I caught the flu. The beginning of last year.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't get sick very often, but sometimes I get busy.
Mm.
My faith is not as high as it should be.
Mm.
I got things on my mind. I'm worn out, or I'm not reading as much or spending as much focused time as I need to
mm-hmm.
in God's word about healing.
Mm.
And man, that thing got on me.
Mm.
Whew, it took me 3 or 4 days to drive it out.
Mm-hmm.
I had to get my word out. I got scriptures out. I began to confess them. I'm feeling awful, but I could feel as 2 or 3 days go by that healing was coming into my body.
Mm.
You know, we fight it a whole different way. We have mm-hmm. other options than to wait it out.
Mm.
You know, some people wait it out. It never leaves.
Mm.
They die.
Mm.
You can't live like you used to. You're not who you used to be. You're not just a better creation. You're a new creation.
Jesus.
So you have to learn how to fight in the kingdom.
Yeah.
Because the devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And he's got game.
Mm-hmm.
He'll talk you out of your healing if you let him.
Mm.
Right? So we've got to fight. We've got to get our scriptures out, begin to confess the word of God.
Amen.
Amen.
My wish above all is that you prosper and that you're in good health.
Good health.
Even as your soul prospers.
Ooh, you got to get that word in your soul.
Come on.
Your mind, your feelings have to be alive with it.
Yeah.
Your emotions have to be alive with it. You can't get to the palace talking like a pauper.
Mm.
You can't get to the wholeness and healing of God. Oh, I feel horrible. My gosh, my hair hurts. My teeth hurt. Everything hurts. This virus.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Now you got to start rising up.
Yeah.
Get in the word of God.
Amen. That's so
He's
good.
Giving you a way to do it. Right? Here it is. Meditate in the word day and night.
Mm.
Night and day.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll be like a tree planted by the rivers of water.
Amen.
Whose leaf will not wither even in a dry season.
Amen.
Come on. Your roots will go deep and be connected to the washing of the water of the word. That river of life.
So good.
So no matter what's happening on the outside above the surface, healing is starting to take place in your body.
Mm-hmm.
Quickening your mortal body.
Amen.
I love it.
Jesus.
I love it. Come on, y'all write it.
So good.
Comment.
Yeah.
I want you to send your questions in. Let me know what you liked about it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh.
I love healing.
Amen.
I love to stay healed.
Yeah.
Right?
We got to keep it. I think that's something believers tend to not necessarily, necessarily walk in.
Right.
The fact that we need to be filled and be being filled. It's about receiving God's being the baptism of the Holy Spirit, but baptism of the Holy Spirit is consistent. We're filled and overflowing, and it's a consistent flow. God's pouring out by His word through worship as we come together, you know.
I like to say it this way. The word and the spirit work together.
Mm-hmm.
The spirit of God confirms the preaching of the word.
Mm.
That's what it says in Mark,
mm-hmm.
that the Holy Spirit went with them confirming the word that they preached.
Mm-hmm.
Every time, in the name of Jesus, by His stripes I'm healed. Man, the Holy Spirit starts moving in that word and makes it come alive in you.
Yeah.
And that's powerful. He empowers us.
That's right.
To receive healing.
Yeah.
I like Hebrews chapter 1. Let's go there.
Yeah.
You got a second?
Yes, sir. Hey, we're here.
Alive.
Amen.
Let me read it. This is going to annoy some of these people that are prophets out there.
Uh-oh.
We still believe in the prophet's ministry. Don't get me wrong.
Amen.
God, verse 1, who at various times and in various ways spoke in times past to the fathers by the prophets.
Mm-hmm.
And we know that. All the prophets that are in the Old Testament, God used them to speak His will to the people, right?
Mm-hmm.
And has in these last days spoken to us by His Son, Jesus Christ, the Word of God. So we have our directions. We have what God thinks, His wisdom, His knowledge, His understanding. It's in the Word of God.
Mm-hmm.
And He speaks His will to us through the Word of God.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there are great people that prophetically change directions of nations.
Mm.
They'll speak out the will of God for a nation or a certain situation. But there's power in that.
Mm-hmm.
It's just not somebody coming along and saying something that wows you, something that's powerful, that transforms. Because we don't have to go to a man now to get a word. We have the word of God, and we can get it right from Jesus Christ. Let me read it again. God, who at various times and in various ways spoke in times past to the fathers by the prophets, has in these last days, I like it that he said we're in the last days. Why? Because this is the church age. When he says, go into all the world and make disciples, and I'll go with you to the ends of the age. He's talking about the church age. The church age has a calendar. It has a beginning and it has an end. One day the church age is going to end. The rapture is going to come, and those last days are going to be over. Then the tribulation. So let me, I'm getting off. Okay. He has in these last days spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things, through whom he also he made the worlds, who being the brightness of his glory and express image of his person, upholding all things by the word of his power. By the word of his power. That's a strange way of putting it to me. You would think it's the power of his word. But what it's saying is that the word is the power of his power. The word is powerful. It is enabled and encouraged and inspired by the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God. As we get with the word of God, believe it, trust in the word of God, the Holy Spirit empowers that word in us, and it becomes alive in us.
Amen.
Amen. That's what we need.
Ooh.
I like it. Amen. You got to stay healed, right?
That's right.
Stay healed.
Yeah.
Whew. What else? What else are we thinking?
Jesus. I know that in these times, you might be out there, you need answers, and I think the flesh automatically goes to panic mode, anxiety. I know there might be a lot of people out there listening, dealing with it. I mean, if you were to just watch the news for more than 10 minutes, you're definitely ready to.
Yeah, you're getting way. Where's the chariots of fire?
Yeah, yeah.
Where are they?
So I think it. It'd be a blessing to maybe minister to those people who might be experiencing some of that anxiety.
Yeah, you know, that's why I like to always live in view of eternity.
Yeah.
Because the good news is that you have forever with God.
Amen.
That you're saved. The good news is that no matter what's going on right now, this has an end date. And that we're going to be with him forever and ever.
Amen.
You know, the second coming of Christ is mentioned 8 times more frequently in the Old and New Testament than his first coming. It's the most important message of the whole Bible, except it's only second to the subject of salvation. If you took the second coming of Christ out of the Bible, the New Testament wouldn't make any sense to you.
Wow.
It's all, Paul builds it around the return of the Lord Jesus Christ. Two phases of the second coming, the rapture of the church. Jesus will come and receive us to himself. And then his second coming where he finishes off the tribulation. And then we will be with him forever and ever.
Wow.
Right? So it's mentioned 318 times in the New Testament alone. That's more mentioned more than chapters in the New Testament.
Wow.
So he can't stop talking about it. So I want to put your mind at ease. The second coming is a real thing. We're going to be with him. But until that happens, you have to take your eyes off things that makes you want to love the earth. He said we're sojourners. We're passing through. If you keep your identity in Christ and not that you're here just to make the most of the earth, and make the earth work out, I've got news for you. The earth doesn't work out. We can read in the Bible that it's going to be, the whole thing is going to be done away with, and he's going to bring a new heaven and a new earth. So if you'll stop having your identity and just who you are here on the earth and see yourself with him forever and ever, then you can handle what's happening right now. It won't overtake you because you know it has an end date. But let me pray for you, for those who are fearful, those whose minds are tormented. Here's what I want you to do. I want you just to open up your heart and say this with me. Maybe, Prince, you could just repeat it with them.
Amen.
Say, Father.
Father.
I want to know you.
I want to know you.
In a real way.
In a real way.
Not religious.
Not religious.
If I'm missing anything.
If I'm missing anything.
Show me.
Show me.
Jesus.
Jesus.
I want to know you more.
I want to know you more.
That you're my Savior.
That you're my Savior.
You're my Lord.
You're my Lord.
You died on a cross for me.
You died on a cross for
Paid
me.
For all my sins.
Paid for all my sins.
I believe that.
I believe that.
God raised you from the dead.
God raised you from the dead.
I believe that, Lord.
I believe that, Lord.
Now I want to know.
And I want to know.
How to live for you.
How to live for you.
I've tried to do it on my own.
I've tried to do it on my own.
I can't do it.
I can't do it.
I'm not strong enough.
I'm not strong enough.
I need your power.
I need your power.
I need your strength.
I need your strength.
Fill me.
Fill me.
Baptize.
Baptize me.
With the Holy Spirit of God.
With the Holy Spirit of God.
I want all of God.
I want all of God.
In all of me.
In all of me.
On my life.
On my life.
Empower me.
Empower me.
To be a witness.
To be a witness.
Of Jesus Christ.
Of Jesus Christ.
I just thank you.
I thank you.
That perfect love.
That perfect love.
Cast out all fear.
Cast out all fear.
I have nothing to be afraid of.
I have nothing to be afraid of.
You are with me.
You are with me.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Can stand successfully against.
Stand successfully against me.
I can be strong.
I can be strong.
In the Lord.
In the Lord.
In the power of his might.
In the power of his might.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
By your stripes.
By your stripes.
I am healed.
I am healed.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Come on, if you pray that prayer for the very first time, Prince, how do they contact us?
Again, it's going to be www.ihpchurch.org. Don't forget to download the In His Presence Church LA app. We actually have a submission form on there. You can find more about salvation, about baptism, once we're able to get back into those things. And just really connect with us in His Presence Church LA on our social media platforms. That's Instagram, Facebook, our YouTube as well. All
Good.
Of those great platforms, yeah.
Good. And be listening, because we're going to not only do this podcast, but Desiree and I are going to do one. And I'm telling you, there's just no telling what she'll say. I'm a little nervous about it. Y'all be praying for me. But we're going to have one out this week, and we're going to do these every week. And just stay connected with you. Again, if you want to hear more about End Times, the book of Revelation, I'd love to do something every week on that if I could. Mm. It would be awesome. I love ministering on that book. Mm. But I'd love to do it with people that have questions. So bring your questions in. I'd love to answer them for you. So we love you, Prince. Great
Amen.
To see you.
Mel Ayres alive.
Great
always
to be
living
with
in view of eternity.
Amen.
It's always a blessing, Pastor.
Amen. And we love you. So watch us online. It'll be Sunday, 9 and 11, and then Wednesday night also. We love you. God bless you.
God bless.